We are going to discuss about metals. Then we will discuss about non-metals and metallics. Okay, so in our modern periodic table, you know what is modern periodic table? Where all the elements are present in a tabular form. Okay, that arrangement is called as modern periodic table. Okay, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, in our modern periodic table, 118 elements are present. How many? 118 elements are present. Okay. Out of 118 elements, 94 elements are metals. Yes. Comma. 94 and then 17 elements, yes, are non-metals. And 7 elements are metalloids. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. This is a very important point that we have discussed now. So now we are going to discuss the next point. What are metals basically? Okay, so I am writing here the heading called metals. Any idea about metals? Yes, Sachi. Any idea about metals? What are metals?
Metal is an element that is malleable and ductile and conducts electricity.
Yes, okay. So I'm going to explain you about the different thing about metals. So metals are elements which have tendency to lose electrons are called as metal. Means they have tendency to lose electron. Metal will lose electron. Okay, that whenever element having tendency to lose electron, that will be metal. That will be metal. Okay. So if somebody will or anybody will ask you what are metals, so you would say elements which have tendency to lose electron are called as metals. And those they will lose electron, they form positive ion. That's why they are called as electropositive element. So I'm writing here, metals are electropositive in nature. Electropositive in nature. Understood, beta? I am writing example over here. Example, we have sodium, we have magnesium, we have aluminium, we have
silver and
calcium, we have silver, we have gold, we have iron, ferrous, we have zinc. Okay, we have 94 metals. Okay, so these are metals. So now we are going to discuss about non-metals. Okay, now we are going to discuss about non-metals. So what are non-metals? thus opposite of the metal. Here, elements have tendency to lose electron. There will be element of tendency to gain electron. Okay, that will be non-metals. Okay, so I'm writing here a definition. Elements which have tendency means the mental status, tendency to gain electron, gain, or we can say accept electrons, are called as non-metal. Okay, and here metals are electropositive, but non-metals are electronegative because they form negative ions. So I'm writing here non-metals are electronegative in nature. Okay, they are electronegative in nature. Example, we have fluorine, we have oxygen, we have nitrogen, we have carbon, we have bromine, we have iodine, etc. Okay, all these are non-metal. We have, okay, all these are nothing but the non-metal. Understood, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here again, sulfur, phosphorus is also there. Okay, so these are all non-metal. So now I want you to take a screenshot because we are going to discuss about metalloids now. Take a screenshot, beta.
Sir, taken.
Okay, so I'm going to discuss about the metalloids. Okay, so third point, we are going to discuss metalloids. Any idea about metalloids?
Yes, sir.
What are metalloids?
The elements store some properties of metal, and some other properties of non-metal are called as metalloids.
Yes, you are right. Absolutely right. Okay, so I'm going to write definition over here, like little different definition, whatever we have in our notes. Okay, so metalloids are the elements which have properties of both metals as well as non-metals. Okay, elements which have properties of both metals as well as non-metals are called as metalloids. Means like some property they will show like metal and other properties are like non-metal. So such elements have 10 properties of both metal as well as non-metal are called as metalloids. So I'm going to write example over here. Okay, so first metalloid we have, which is boron. Okay, next we have silicon, next we have gallium, next we have germanium. I think germanium is not gallium, it's germanium, huh? Because GT is germanium. Then we have antimony. Yes, antimony is AF. It is also called as antimony is the name. Then we have bismuth, which is Sb. Okay, then we have tellurium is Pe, and we have polonium. Okay, the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So these are the seven metalloids do we have in our modern periodic table? Okay, which are they? One is called boron.
Silicon.
Silicon.
Germanium.
Then we have arsenic. Then we have bismuth. Then it is also called as antimony. Bismuth is also called as antimony. Antimony. Then we have tellurium. And we have polonium. Okay, polonium. So these are the seven metalloids we have in our modern periodic table, which have properties of both metal as well as non-metal. Okay, beta. So this is all about metal, non-metal, and metalloids. So again, I want you to take a screenshot for that.
That is one.
Okay. So let's see, what do we have in our notes? Oxygen is non-metal, beta. Oxygen, carbon are non-metal.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You have written on your screen, so you can erase it because it is going to disturb you. Okay. So now we are going to discuss from your notes. Okay. So here we have metals. Metals are C. Wait a second, let me change the ink. Yeah. So metals are the solid material, but we have one metal which is in liquid state called mercury.
Mercury.
Yes. Which is typically hard. Metals have hard, shiny. It is a luster property. It is hardness. Malleable means we can convert them into the thin sheet. Then fusible, we can mix with other metals in their molten state. Ductile, we can draw into the thin wire. And good electrical conduct and thermal conductivity means electricity and heat can pass through them. All these properties of and comes under metals. Example, we have aluminium, we have copper, iron, tin, gold, silver, and whatever we have written, all these are metals. Now we are going to discuss about where is non-metal. Yes, non-metal is here. After metalloid, we have non-metal. So now we are going to discuss about the metalloid. So metalloids exhibit some properties of metal as well as non-metal. Means they have property of both metal as well as non-metal are called as metalloid. Example, we have boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, antimony, tellurium, and polonium. Okay, all these are metalloids. They are metalloids. Okay, now we have non-metals also. So non-metals are the brittle and are not malleable or ductile. So they are sometimes brittle, but they are not malleable, neither ductile. Okay, and they are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Only the diamond is good conductor of heat. Diamond is good conductor of heat, and graphite is a non-metal being good conductor of electricity. You know that? Now you know. Diamond, yes, being a non-metal is have good conductor of electricity, whereas graphite being non-metal is good conductor of electricity. Diamond is for heat, graphite is for electricity. So both are non-metals and are allotropes of carbon. Okay. For example, here we have boron. Let's see, carbon, boron should not be there because boron comes under metalloid. So boron
metalloid.
Boron should not be here. Okay, so this is all about the non-metal. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the compounds. So compounds are the substance considering two or more different or same kind of, if they contain same time, then it is called as element. If they are of different element they contain, then it is called as compound. Like water. Water is a compound formed by hydrogen and water, oxygen. Carbon dioxide is a compound which is formed by carbon and oxygen. Glucose, C6H12O6, is a compound which is formed by 6 carbon, 6 oxygen, and 12 hydrogen. Okay, so all these are compounds. Okay, So now we are going to discuss about the difference between mixture and compound. So mixture are constituted by more than one kind of pure form of the matter, okay, are known as substance. They are substance and they contain two or more than two type of different elements are called as mixture. Okay, then mixture are classified as homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. When two or more elements chemically combine in a fixed ratio, which is called as compound. Okay, and in a mixture, ratio of you can say proportion of two substances is not fixed, but in compound the proportion of element is fixed. Okay, so this is the basic difference between mixture and compound. Okay, beta, any doubt here?
No, sir.